Hey everybody, on today's episode of Tutorial Tuesday Tech Team Edition, wow, that is a mouthful. I'll tell you what we're gonna do. We're actually gonna do a tech tour, and I'm gonna show you kind of what all we have here, what areas there are to serve, and how everything's actually hooked up and ran. Just a brief overview, a bird's eye view, if you will. So won't you join me as we go exploring the stage here at the Cabot campus and the tech booth, and hopefully we'll hit a few other of our That Church venues real soon. Check this out. Okay, so we're gonna start things out here in the tech booth. This is at the very back of the worship center, and this is where we run the lyrics, we run lights, and where we run our audio from. So let me just kind of start down here and let's walk it through. This is our media area where we run ProPresenter. These are our lyric slides. And anything you see on the screen, this is actually where it comes from. So let me just give you a quick little rundown here. Let me close out of that. So this is last week's service. So as we go through, we got our little welcome area. Then we go to song number one and we just kind of click on the lyric slides as we go. I know that's kind of hard to see, but as we go through this little area here, it changes what we see on the screen. How cool is that? And then of course we have our lighting software, which is Vista. I know it looks like there's a lot going on here, but for most Sundays at our smaller campus, it's actually a pretty simple operation. And really these little squares right here represent just different points in the service where we change lighting scenes. So this is actually what we consider one of our entry points here, here and media, because they're pretty simple. So that's that. We got lyrics, we got lights, and then of course we have sound, which right now we are currently, because of the COVID-19 situation, running everything digitally through a software-based mixer, which is this over here. And it's pretty cool. It's relatively new to what we're doing. We were previously using it for our monitor mixes, but in order to keep things clean every week and to keep from damaging equipment, it was simpler just to give a keyboard and a mouse a wipe down. And then of course you can save the scenes for each song and parts of songs. And of course here is our rack of stuff where we have our wireless equipment and, or at least the wireless receivers for our mics, my monitor pack send, and of course where everything comes into the system. And there you go, that's the media booth. And let's just kind of break down what we're seeing here. Let's start with these cool little LED panels here. All right, all this is, believe it or not, these were built here. They are wooden frames, and then they have LED tape light inside lining them. You can kind of see the LED tape light if I get really close right there. And then we have fabric on top of them and just some little wood strips for trim. And of course, it's kind of hard to see, but here is where the power supplies are for them, which I would love to do another video soon on how we actually made those and set them up. And of course, we got our screens that were made by volunteers, actually. That is PVC pipe frame with some screen material that we got off of Amazon and works pretty good. Got this nifty little lighting rig. Not all of them are on at the moment. Okay, this is an instrument station. The instrument station is where we hook in our instruments. This is where our bass player hooks in. And what we have going on here, of course, is a simple tuner ran into a Sansamp powered DI to kind of fake the sound of a mic'd amplifier, going into a Rolls, which doubles as a DI and their headphone amp all in one. Up front, right here on the stage, is one of our vocalist stations. So to keep stage clutter to a minimum, we built these little trap doors. So when the singers are done during the video, waiting for the pastor to come out, they can neatly put their vocal mics in the trap door, and that's where we keep them. And there's one over there on the other side also. And then of course we have the worship leader mic that I'm normally on, and my handy dandy little panic button there, which allows me to talk to the team and to the sound booth without anybody knowing about it, which is really nice. And yes, believe it or not, we actually use a digital drum set here. This was donated to us. That's probably the big reason we use it. You can actually get a halfway decent live sound if you know what you're doing. We put the kick and the toms all on one channel, and then we put the snare and the cymbals all on one channel, so that keeps the highs and the lows semi-separated. Right beside the drummer is our track software, and we actually use playback here. Mostly for its simplicity and just the cleanliness of the rig. Everything's just pretty much good to go. We download our tracks every week to it. It's a pretty simple operation. They just hit play. And then as needed, they can crossfade, pause, and jump to different parts of the set. And that comes out of a single cable here, going into our interface, which splits it up into about six different signals. And then, of course, we got this handy-dandy little switcher here. In the event that we don't have a live drummer, somebody else on stage can control the tracks. And finally, our audio comes in over here. This is our drive rack and amp rack. And these amps go to these speakers hanging in the ceiling right there. And then, of course, we have our subs on the floor right there. So here is our stage entrance, and to my left we have this door, which is our supply closet where we keep our mics, earpieces, and batteries and things of that nature. We've got some documentation that talks about our order of rehearsal and run through on Sunday morning. A supply closet that is labeled and everything is in its proper place. A closet that I'm scared to go into. Maybe some other time. Charlie Brown's Christmas tree. Storage for envelopes, pens, and other things that go in the seat backs. And then back here is what we call our green room. And yes, it is green, kind of a teal color. And this is where we kind of hang out before we go out on stage, where we do some team meetings and whatnot. And then, of course, a back exit door so we can walk out and around. And of course, something kind of new that we've added is we have a camera feed now that actually goes to our fellowship area as a family room. And that's just a simple Panasonic camera going HDMI to a converter that converts it to Ethernet that goes to a TV in the other room. And then of course it receives its feed via aux going into a converter to clean up the audio into the camera itself. That was actually a lot of fun. I look forward to doing some more of these. Pretty soon we're going to do some videos where we go into more detail on each of these areas, the sound, the lighting, and the media. And hopefully we're going to have some tours of other areas pretty soon, such as our Sherwood campus, and hopefully future venues that we're going to be launching in the near future. This way we can learn from each other and help each other grow in our ministries. I hope everybody's had fun watching this, and we'll see you next week. Have a great day, everybody. And this right here is a miniature sized Godzilla trying to play the keyboard.